Today we will discuss about the Paulo Freire and his educational philosophy. This Paulo Freire and his educational philosophy we will be discussing in two parts. The first part is we will see the life sketch of Paulo Freire, and in the second part we will see the educational philosophy of Paulo Freire. Why it is required to understand the life sketch of a philosopher before understanding the educational philosophy of the philosopher is because it is the condition, it is a situation in which the philosophy of a philosopher develops. Okay, so that's why we try to understand the life sketch of a philosopher. What prevailed them to think in that perspective? And it is not only with the educational philosophy. In general, when we talk, it is a thought process. So what prevailed them to think in that light? If we want to understand about the any person, that what is prevailing them to think in that way, then first we have to understand the situation in which they have grown up. Like that, when you will talk about the Mahatma Gandhi, like that when you will talk about the Aurobindo, like that when you will talk about the Tagore, when you will talk about their educational philosophy, the point of suppression, the point of labor, this thing will not come because they have not witnessed that, isn't it? Whatever they will be witnessing, that will lead to develop their thought process. It develops that. It is developed in that manner. So that's why when we talk about any philosopher, it is very important to understand what prevailed them to think in that line. What was prevailing? What was happening that lead to thought, develop their thought process in that way? That's why we require to understand the life sketch of a philosopher. And side by side, when we will be seeing the different philosophers, then you will try to link that whatever the life sketch of a philosopher is there, that is leading them to think in that way. Like that, when we talk about the Karl Marx. Karl Marx is also a very great philosopher of the world. When you will find, when you will see the philosophy of Karl Marx, then you will find the conscientiousness, class, labor, this type of a concept will come. Because the Karl Marx is grown in that situation. Similarly, when we talk about the Paulo Freire, Paulo Freire was the one of the great philosopher, most influential philosopher in the area of education in the 20th century. And when we see the work of a Paulo Freire, he has worked wholeheartedly to help the people through his educational philosophy and the practices of the critical pedagogy. What is the critical pedagogy? Probably we will see in the next class. So through the practice of a critical pedagogy and through his philosophical ideas, he tried to help the people with wholeheartedly. He was a native of Brazil, and Freire's goal was to eradicate illiteracy among the people from previously colonized countries and the continents, because he has been grown in the country which was under the colonial system of Portugalese, and he has seen the situation of the colonialism So he tried to eradicate the illiteracy among the people who were suffering from the colonialism. And when we see the insight, you will find the root is in the social and political realities of the children and the grandchildren of the former slaves. So in that context, his life grew. And that's why his idea, life and work are to serve the and the upgrade the living condition of the oppressed people. Isn't it? So that's why he used to write the pedagogy of oppression. So in that context, his life begins. When we see the condition of Brazil, that is the colonized Brazil, we find that the Brazil was under the colonialism of the Portuguese between the time frame of 1500 century to 1822. And in that time, in the Ferry context, okay, then at that time, Brazil people were punished and they were working as a slave of the Portuguese. Brazil people are perished due to the harsh and forced labor condition, and because they did not have any immunity to the European disease, because the Brazil was under the colonialism of the Portugals and Europeans country. So the people, those who were coming to the Brazil, and they were obviously coming to the disease that was affecting the Brazilian people, and they were not having the immunity of those European disease, because those disease was not native to the European Brazilian country. So they died, and at that time the economy of the Brazil was based upon the sugar mills. And since the people were also dying, so the Portuguese, they were even using their dead bodies in the sugar mill to get the, because when we see the sugar mills, the sugar cane juice are heated to make a sugar. So that type of harassment, that type of punishment, that type of a situation in the Brazil was undergoing. Even Brazil was the primarily a commercial enterprise for the Portuguese. So that's why they have exploited not only the people of Brazil, but the resources too. Okay, until the end of 1808. And the literacy among the Brazilian was almost nil. They were not literate. So in this context, the birth of Paulo Freire comes in 1921. Okay, at that time, the Brazil was independent. But the effect of colonialism was still existing at that time. And in the year 1930, a Great Depression came. So the livelihood opportunity was even nil. So even at that time, the so many Brazilian family, they were selling themselves into slavery to avoid the starving. Starving means that is the hunger. So they were selling and they were becoming the slaves. even when we see the early life of Paulo Freire. So Paulo Freire was accepting that in the so many circumstances he used to steal food for his family because of the hunger, and there was almost no resources for the livelihood. He took birth in the 1921, and then the country was overcoming from the colonialism, and in the 1930 the Great Depression came. So he admits that in the so many time he was stealing food to satisfy his hunger and for his family too. And in this context, Paulo Freire started schooling, but he dropped out from the elementary school to work and to help his family financially. He forced to drop out from the school, and it was a time of a very hardship for the Paulo Freire in that time. Somehow in this context, Paulo Freire managed to finish this elementary schooling, and later he attended a secondary school also. Okay, and he studied law also from the School of Law, RECFI, during the 1943 to 1947. When we see the influence on the Paulo Freire's life and his philosophy, we find that Paulo Freire was greatly influenced by the Karl Marx ideas, and he accepts the philosophical ideology of Karl Marx can be seen in his philosophy. Okay, among the ideas from the Karl Marx that influence Paulo Freire are the Marx class of consciousness and his concept of labor and a false consciousness. For Marx, when we talk Marx, when a person gains awareness of their class consciousness, they become cognizant of their economic place in their society and thus their class interest. The point of saying is that the moment the person will get education, get literacy, they will start understanding their position in the society. And education is a tool by which they can come out of those situations. So the incident of a class, the incident of a labors, that have influenced a lot the Paulo Freire. Even Paulo Freire admits that one of the Brazilian philosopher, Assino Teixeira, and his work also influenced Paulo Freire to a large extent. In the Teixeira work called The Democratization of Brazilian Society Through Education, there is a one work by the Assino Teixeira. In this work, Assino Teixeira argues that the Brazilian society were not able to get their right, not able to get their livelihood, because of the oppression, because of the ignorance, because of the non-existence of the education. Teixeira opposed the education of his time, opposed the kind of education that was prevailing at that time, which was exclusively for the upper class and thus promotes the social elitism and left the majority of Brazilians without access to the education. Because education is a tool by which you can eradicate all those evil practices. But the education was not available to the majority of Brazilian, rather than it was for the upper class, which was promoting the social elitism. And it was by leaving the majority of Brazilians without access to the education. Then, in this context, Teixeira's work was for establishing free, public, and a secular education. The education must be free for everybody. It must be publicly available. Public education system means it is a duty of a government to organize educational program for its people. So, education should be a public effort, the government effort. And it should be a secular one. Secular means it should be available to all class and people without any discrimination. So in this context, that Paulo Freire was influenced by the Assino Teixeira. Even Assino Teixeira says that the education must be designed in a such a way that it should move from traditional hierarchical system of education to the authoritarian way in which people have related to each other, and they must get equal opportunity for education. So that was the philosophical view on education of the Assino Teixeira. And this also influenced the Paulo Freire. Why it is influenced? When we see the Karl Marx and when we see the Assino Teixeira, they were influencing Paulo Freire. Why they were influencing? Because Paulo Freire has born and grown up in a situation where he has seen so many discrimination, slavery, injustice in his life. And he has struggled for earning his livelihood during the hardship, during the Great Depression of 1930s. So in this context, the Paulo Freire groans. Even when we see the John Dewey was another person who have influenced Paulo Freire to a great extent, especially the way of and the modality of imparting education and the classroom dynamics. Because we know that John Dewey is one of the prominent philosophers in the area of constructivism, which have given a different perspective of student-teacher relationship in the educational system. We know that in the behaviorism, the kind of student-teacher relationship was different. When we talk about the constructivism, the student-teacher relationship was different. So, John Dewey's philosophy on the interaction of student and teacher, the classroom dynamics, has influenced Paulo Freire to a large extent. And when we will talk about the critical pedagogy that was proposed by Paulo Freire, you will find the essence of constructivism and essence of John Dewey's philosophy, essence of Assino Teixeira philosophy, and essence of Karl Marx, all the things you will see in his critical pedagogy. And he has opposed the banking system, banking model of education that was prevailing at that time. What is the banking system? which system was there and why he termed it as a banking system. Banking system model is the name given was the Pallavi. We will see also that. And when we see the John Dewey's philosophy, there was a different dynamics and a different perspective in the teacher-student relationship was proposed by the John Dewey. Even at that time, the educational philosophy, the school of philosophy, that is the existentialism, was also influenced by Pallavi. He was getting influence and he was framing his own philosophy. He was seeing what is happening in and around. Not only that, what kind of a suffering he was having, but also what kind of good thing is happening in and around the world. And he was relating the things which with his own life. And he was taking the essence of everything and he was framing his own philosophical thought for the education. When we talk about the existentialism, this philosophy believes that the all human need their own dignity, their own right of a life, their freedom, the freedom of a life, and the education as a system, it must ensure the freedom and a right of a life, dignity in the life. That was not given to the Brazilians. During the Portuguese colonialism and even after that, and after that in 1930 Great Depression came. So in the Great Depression time, we know that when the economical crisis comes in any country, it used to affect the life of a people in a variety of way. It is not only that it will affect economically, it will also affect their democratic life, democratic rights. Like that, when you will see that during this pandemic, you can relate. During this pandemic, it is not only that it is only a risk to the life of a people. It is also a time when the risk on their justice, social right, democratic right is cut down. You may say that it is for the establishing better health condition in the country. Yes, it is right. But at the same time, it is denying their right of a justice. We know that it has been more than 1.5 year, and judiciary system, courts are not functioning well. Why it is not functioning well? Only the case which are very important that are being going for the hearing. But there are a lot of a thing in the court. And if it is not coming for a hearing, then the justice on the part of a people is denied. In so many, when we see the Bihar, in the Bihar, panchayat election is not conducted. It is denying their democratic right. We are denying. I am not trying to say that this should not happen and we should conduct the election. No, this is not my point. My point is that because when this type of a hard situation will come, it will affect the life of a people in a various dimension. It is not only that it have a effect on their health, it will affect in the various dimension. So in this context, the life of the Paulo Freire goes, where he have seen so many type of discrimination, denying from their natural right of life, natural right of justice, he has been denied. So that's why existentialism also influenced the Paulo Freire to a large extent. Then when we see the other thing, in the philosophical belief of Paulo Freire, he believes that the equal importance to the theoretical aspect, spiritual aspect, and the equal importance on the developing the opportunity of a livelihood must be emphasized when the point of education comes. Because he seen the so many exploitations. And in this context, his educational philosophy comes. And he talks that the education must be acting as an agent to liberate from all the ill practices. Education must be worked for the development of a creative and a critical thinking. Because only getting education will not eradicate all type of ill practices. It should root in the thought process of the person. Because when we talk about the colonialism, Portuguese colonialism in the Brazil, or even when we talk about the India, or even when talk about the so many country, it was not like that they were not educated. But they failed to think in that way, that they are denying their natural right of a justice, natural right of a life, natural right of a providing employment opportunity, natural right of a dignity. The education was not functioning to develop these quality. And in this context, the critical pedagogy, philosophy of critical pedagogy, he brings. Even when we talk about his writing, one of the very famous writing is that Pedagogy of Oppressed. He talks that how these people can be taught, those who are oppressed since a long time, whose thought process is not able to think in a line that they must get education, and they identified the value of education. He also talks that what could be the dynamics of a teacher and a student in the teaching learning process to establish a healthy relationship between teacher and a student. And that's why he opposed the banking model of education, which was prevailing at that time. We will see those things later on in the second class. So when you will talk his educational philosophy, his aim of the philosophy as per his aim of the education as per his philosophy, you will find this type of input, because he has grown, he has seen those situations in his country, in his life. But when we talk about the other philosophers, when we talk about the even the educational philosophy of John Dewey, isn't it? This type of exploitation, slavery, labor, and all those things will not come in his philosophy. When we talk about the Gandhiji's philosophy, his context was different, and that's why he emphasized earn while learning, work-oriented education, developing of a livelihood opportunity, development of a skill out of the education system. When we talk about the Tagore, so you will not find this type of input, because Tagore was born and brought up in a very elite family, elite class. He has completed his education in the foreign. So I'm not saying that going foreign is a big deal, but in order to go foreign at that time, you must be economically very sound. If you are not very much economically sound, then you cannot think of going. So this was the relevance of understanding the life sketch of a philosopher to understand their philosophy.